Thank you for joining us this evening, and this is going to be just a little sharing about the reality of the fact that we are now the sons of Yahuah. And if you've been born of the Ruach, born of the Spirit of Yahuah, we are now a part of His family. We are now we have His Spirit, which makes us one with Him. I'm going to share some verses in 1 John, or 1 Yahuchanan, chapter 3, and I'll start reading at verse 1. It says, "Behold," or look, "what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of Yahuah." Now, my English translation actually reads "the sons of God," but we know that the word God has been substituted a number of times for the name of Yahuah, and also the word Lord has as well. But that's why I'm reading it this way here, is because this is really, God is not even an accurate transliteration of the word. It was actually Elohim or Elohim, which would mean translated "mighty one." Is talking about Yahuah here. So I'm just going to use His name because I know that's who it's referring to. "Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of Yahuah. Therefore the world knows us not, because it knew Him not." Then it says, "Beloved, now are we the sons of Yahuah." Didn't say once we die and go to heaven or anything like that. It says, "Beloved, now are we the sons of Yahuah. And it doesn't yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when He shall appear," this is talking about at His coming, when he appears, "we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is." Now, this reference of likeness is not talking about a physical likeness, like we're going to have a physical resemblance of Him. There will be the fact that we'll have a glorified, resurrected body as He does, but it's making reference to much more than that. It's making, as He is, so are we. Yahusha came and paid the price for our sins, was nailed to a cross, paid the price for our sins, and as He became the firstborn from the dead, as the scripture talks about, then we, as the redeemed, we also will be resurrected and raised to life. This corruptible body of ours will put on incorruption. This mortal will put on immortality. And at that time that He appears, and this is covered in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, if you'll read through the whole chapter there, that it talks about that this corruptible must put on incorruption and this mortal must put on immortality. And we will have our resurrected bodies, but right now, the reality of that we are now the sons of Yahuah is because that the moment that you, by faith, accept the Mashiach and you call upon Yahuah as your salvation, and you have His Ruach, you have His Spirit, you're now born of His Spirit. We have been born again, or born from above, as Yahusha declared in John chapter 3, that you must be born again or born from above in order to enter the kingdom of Yahuah. And the moment that a person does that, then they are united with Him. They're now sons or daughters of Yahuah because we have and we've partaken of His Ruach, of His Spirit. When the reality of that, you know, will get to you, and the understanding of that, you know, the scripture says the Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of Yahuah. See, you have, if you're born again, born from above, you have His Spirit, you should have the witness that you belong to Him. And because of that fact, that reality of that, and we're just waiting for the adoption to be complete, the redemption of these bodies of ours. That's what Shaul wrote in the book of Romans, that we're waiting for the adoption to be complete, the redemption of our bodies. I mean, that's going to be a glorious, awesome time to think about, that these bodies of ours will no longer be subject to corruption. They will no longer be subject to aging and sickness and disease And that we will have a resurrected immortal body that will live forever, will not age, will not change. And I don't know about you, but I'm excited about that aspect, that that I will have a resurrected new body that has been recreated by our Father Yahuah. But the moment that you, by faith, receive Him as your Savior, you know, that on the inside, the scripture talks about that there's a new man. Paul wrote about this in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 4, where he said that he encouraged us to put on the new man, which after Yahuah is created in righteousness and true holiness, or set apartness. Now, what he's making reference to is the fact that if you're truly born from above and have the Ruach on the inside of you, then we should allow that new man that you can't see. All you see is my flesh, my physical body. But there's a new man that on the inside of me that's been born of His Spirit, that's already created. Notice that it's not something that's made up. I'm not just a forgiven sinner. I'm a new creature in Mashiach. I have been born of His Spirit. And because of that reality of that, then if I allow that man that lives on the inside to dominate my life, then Paul says that we're to let that new man put on that new man who is already created in righteousness and true holiness. See, the fact of the matter is, if you're born from above, you have His Spirit, you can't do anything to get more righteous or to be more holy. You know, you're as righteous as or as set apart as you can be because you have His Spirit, and that's what makes you righteous. It's not your good works or deeds. Not that we shouldn't do good works or deeds, but the good deeds and works that you do does not perfect you. Your perfection is already taking place on the reality that you're a new creature in Mashiach, that you're born of His Spirit. And that's the reality of your redemption. That's what Yahuah, when He sees you and I, He sees us in the realm of the Ruach. He sees you as His child that has the Spirit of the Mashiach inside you and I. That's what makes us righteous before Him. I'm hoping you're getting this, and we're going to stop here. I'm going to have to cut it off here, and then we'll pick back up on our next session talking about the reality that we're now sons of Yahuah and that we have this completion of the new man that's on the inside made righteous before our Father. And knowing this aspect of our redemption will give you power, confidence to live until Yahusha or until Yahuah comes and receives us unto Himself, and then this mortal will put on immortality. Well, thank you for joining us this evening, and I look forward to our next session together. Remember, Baruch Haba Hashem Yahuah, blessed is He who comes in the name of Yahuah. Shalom.